Before extending the transition function to strings, let's define a function which is called eclosure of a state. It is a recursive definition and the basis goes like this. For a state Q, the epsilon closure of Q will include Q. That is, we are trying to find the epsilon closure of the state Q. And that will include the state Q. That is, Q is an epsilon closure of Q. Induction step is, if state P is in epsilon closure of state Q and there is a transition from state P to R with the label epsilon, then the epsilon closure of Q will also include the state R. That is, we are trying to find the epsilon closure of state Q and P is a member of that. And from P to R, some other state R, we have a transition on epsilon. We have a null string transition from P to Q. In that case, the epsilon closure of Q will also include the state R. Let's work out an example. This is a epsilon transition machine. So the epsilon closure of Q naught will be, using the basis we will have Q naught, and from Q naught we have to identify all the states using the epsilon transition. So from Q naught I can go to Q1 using epsilon. So Q1 will be in the epsilon closure of Q naught. Okay, so this Q1 is now acting as state R and this Q naught is acting as state P. And from Q naught using epsilon transition we can go to Q2. So Q2 will also be there in the epsilon closure of Q naught. And there are no other transitions possible. So we will finish this. Similarly, we can find the epsilon closure of Q1. Using the basis, the epsilon closure of Q1 will be having the state Q1. And from Q1, I don't have any transition using epsilon. So I will not have any other state. And from Q2, the epsilon closure of Q2 will include Q2 using the basis, and from Q2 I can go to Q1 using the epsilon transition, so will include Q1. And finally, the epsilon closure of Q3 will include Q3, and from Q3 I can go to Q2, so I will include this one, and from Q2 I can go to Q1, so I will include Q1 as well. See here, when we have considered the epsilon closure of Q0, we have the epsilon transition directly from Q0 to Q1 and Q2. But when we consider the epsilon transition at Q3, it's not necessary that I have to have a direct transition from Q3 to Q1 upon epsilon. From Q3 we move to Q2 and from using epsilon. And from Q2 we can move to Q1 using epsilon. So both Q2 will and Q1 will appear in the epsilon closure of Q3.